हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. एम आई ऑडिबल? हाउ इज इट गोइंग माय स्टूडेंट्स? हेलो.
ओ सर,
ओ सर,
स्क्रीन शेयर के लिए मैं आ रही हूँ. स्क्रीन पर स्टे करो.
ओ सर, दिस
ओके. सो इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी स्टार्टेड आवर थर्ड यूनिट इन आवर एडवांस मैनेजमेंट प्रोसेसेस. थर्ड यूनिट दैट इज मिलिंग मशीन्स. सॉरी, आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग मिलिंग मशीन we started this gear management, gears. So basically these are the pictures of gears having teeth across its periphery. So you can see that teeth, depending upon the teeth size or teeth position, there are different types of gear. Basically gears are the having tooth on its periphery for transmitting motion as well as power. Due to this gear rotation, we can transmit either motion at speed or either we can transmit power also, depending upon the required condition in our mechanical engineering field. So as in last lecture, we already started this important part, types of gear or gear classification. So as we have studied the first type of gear, that is spur gear. That is one of the simple gear, or it is mostly used for different movements. So the spur gears, then helical gear. We'll just go through this list first of all. Spur gear nantar putcha jeva motion mala maximum motion mala transfer karachi. For spur gear we can use it for light duty applications. And it is widely used. Most of the gears are spur gears, but in some high speed applications or in some high movement, we have to use the helical gears also. Then combination of two helical gears, there is a herringbone gear. Then bevel gear. These are the features of bevel gear. It's not only there is a circular gear, but also some gears in the form of inclined angles. That bevel gears are there. Then bevel gear and the worm gear, like this. This is a worm and having this shaft which is mesh on that worm. So that is a worm gear. Then after this worm gear, there is rack and pinion. That rack and pinion, you can see that this is straight line. That straight plate is the rack, and where is small teeth gear, which is called as a pinion for various movements in various machine tools also. This rack and pinion is used for movement. Okay, then inside or internal gear and external gear. On that periphery of gear, if the gears are on the external side, they are called as an external gear. But when that, as per our required motion, if the gears are inside the periphery, internally they are having the teeth. Now on this, all types of gears, their external gears are there. But in some cases, you may require the internal gear also, depending upon the type of movement. So external gears, internal gears. That is one of the part of gear. Then phase gear, sprockets. So these are the different types of gear which we have to study in details one by one. So we will go to the next part. So in last lecture we already started this spur gear. These are having parallel and coplanar shaft connected by gears. Means the axis of rotation of this gear passing through this internal hole, and axis of this tooth, all this tooth, that is having parallel axis both. So this parallel or coplanar shafts, they are called as the spur gears. These spur gears are most widely used in many industrial applications. Apun jeva bagto this spur gears are most important part of mechanical industry. They are having straight teeth एंड आर पैरेलल टू द एक्सिस ऑफ द व्हील. हां जो ते गियर के सेंटर में जा रहा है, व्हील के सेंटर में जा रहा है एक्सिस है, तो एक्सिस एंड यहां गियर टू द एक्सिस दैट बोथ आर पैरेलल. दैट्स व्हाट इज कॉल्ड एज अ कोप्लैनर शाफ्ट कनेक्टेड बाय गियर्स आर कॉल्ड एज अ स्पर गियर. मींस सपोज बोथ दिस गियर इज हैविंग दिस एक्सिस passing through this center of the gear and this another gear is also having this another axis passing through the center of the gear. So both axis as well as axis from this tooth position, all these axes they are parallel axis, they are coplanar axis, and both these gears are meshing. After meshing properly they will transmit motion from one gear to another gear. तो दिस पर गियर सर आई हैव स्ट्रेट विद वो लिस्ट द ड्राइंग ऑन दिस इज टीथ गाइस स्टूडेंट्स ऑल द टीथ आर पैरेलल एंड दे आर नॉट ओनली पैरेलल टू ईच अदर बट दे आर आल्सो पैरेलल टू द एक्सिस ऑफ गियर और एक्सिस ऑफ व्हील. दैट्स इट पर गियर. द स्क्वायर गियर एडवांटेज क्या है, द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ स्क्वायर गियर्स आर देयर सिंपलिसिटी इन डिजाइन. इट्स डिजाइन दिस इज बाकी क्या बाकी हेलिकल गियर का शोर है देयर एंड सिंपल डिजाइन सिंपलिसिटी इन डिजाइन and economy of manufacturer while manufacturing such gears or spur gears. It doesn't require more cost, they are economical type of gear, and also not only manufacturing economy but also in maintenance also they are not so costly. In maintenance also they are economical spur gears. And absence of end thrust, there is no such more thrust on that tooth while rotation. Spur gears are also known as speed gears, and these spur gears are the most common type of gears, which are called as the speed gear. So we can see in this drawing, these are the examples of spur gears having straight or parallel teeth. These parallel teeth are not only parallel to each other, but also parallel to the axis of rotation, axis of wheel gear. That is your spur gears, which are also called as speed gears, and they are most common types of gear. Then the second next type is helical gears. We already seen that part also in last lecture. Helical gears are such as spur gears, speed gears. They are parallel to each other, but helical gear they have their teeth inclined to the axis of the shafts in the form of helix. या ठिकाणी कसं आहे हेलिकल गियर्स कसे आता दे आर नॉट पॅरलल लाईक स्पर गियर दे आर इन्क्लाइन टू द एक्सिस ऑफ द शाफ्ट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ हेलिक्स दैट इज स्पर गियर. हेलिकल गियर्स सॉरी हेलिकल गियर्स कैन टेक देयर हायर लोड्स देन सिमिलरली साइज स्पर गियर्स. म्हणजे नॉर्मल सिमिलर साइज जे स्पर गियर आहे त्या सिमिलर साइजचा हेलिकल गियर गियर तयार केला पण काय होणार आहे helical gear can take higher loads than your spur gears. Spur gears comparatively load carrying capacity of helical gear is more, so that helical gears lakshat aala sagyanna tumhala tyachi tooth kashe asle that teeth are not parallel to the axis of wheel, they are inclined to the axis of the shaft. Ha shaft cha axis jo je jo gear mount karay sapla na ta axis la इनक्लाइन एंगल मध्ये ते हेलिक गियर्स आहे टूथ आहे बरोबर. दॅट्स व्हाय दे कॅन टेक द हायर लोड देन युअर स्पर गियर ऑफ सेम साइज. द एंगल ऑफ द हेलिक्स ऑन बोथ द गियर मस्ट बी सेम बरोबर. हे जे दोन गियर आपलं मेशिंग करतो आपण फर्स्ट गियर अँड सेकंड गियर आय दिस फर्स्ट गियर अँड दिस सेकंड गियर मग अँगल ऑफ टूथ और अँगल ऑफ द हेलिक्स इज व्हॉट ऑफ द हेलिक्स आर देअर इनक्लाइन अँगल जे हेलिक्स जे दाखवलं आहे एक्सटर्नली तर त्या अँगल कसा असला पाहिजे इट मस्ट बी सेम. It must be same in angle but opposite in direction. इथं बघा तुम्ही याची डायरेक्शन कशी आणि याची डायरेक्शन कशी दे आर सेम अँगल बट देअर डायरेक्शन इज अपोजिट. यू कॅन सी ॲट हिअर ऑल्सो मेशिंग गियर्स येते हा गियर इट इज इन दिस डायरेक्शन वेर एज दिस डायरेक्शन इज डायरेक्शन टीथ आहे. देअर टीथ आर हॅविंग सेम अँगल बट अपोजिट इन डायरेक्शन ओके. राईट हँड पिनियन मेशेस विथ लेफ्ट हँड गियर सो अपोजिट आहे म्हणजे काय होतं राईट हँड पिनियन गियर काय होतो लेफ्ट हँड गियरशी मेश होतो
These gears are considered, usually considered high speed gears, no? High speed च्या application साठी आपल्याला अशा प्रकारचे हेलिकल गिअर वापरला जातो. सो दिस हेलिकल गिअर्स आर द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ राईट हँड गिअर प्लस लेफ्ट हँड गिअर. एंड एज दिस राईट हँड अँड लेफ्ट हँड गिअर्स The teeth are in opposite direction. They are meshing properly, but they are having equal size. So after meshing, it can rotate from one shaft to other shaft, or it can transmit the motion power from one gear to other gear. So wherever we are going, high speed applications. So high speed gears are mostly helical gears used for different power transmission. That's another student's answer. आपण याच्या आधी जे बघितलं स्क्वेअर गिअर, स्क्वेअर गिअर मध्ये काय होतं, म्हणजे स्टिक्स आर पॅरलल टू एक्सिस ऑफ द गिअर, वेअर एज
इन हेलिकल गिअर बोथ गिअर्स आर हॅव्हिंग सेम अँगल ऑफ टूथ, बट दे आर हॅव्हिंग द अपोजिट डायरेक्शन, आयदर राईट हँड गिअर ऑर आयदर लेफ्ट हँड गिअर, अँड देअर टूथ्स आर इन्क्लाइन टू द एक्सिस ऑफ द शाफ्ट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ हेलिक्स. हेलिक्सच्या फॉर्म मध्ये ते दे आर नॉट पॅरल, दे आर हेलिक्स, सॉरी हेलिक्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ इन्क्लाइन अँगल. द इन्क्लाइन अँगल होता अदर दे कॅन यूज इन हाय स्पीड गिअर्स, अँड देअर लोड कॅरिंग कॅपॅसिटी इज ऑल्सो मोर दॅन युअर सेम साईज स्क्वेअर गिअर. बरोबर, एखादा सेम साईजचे दोन हेलिकल गिअर आणि स्क्वेअर गिअर येते, तर त्यामध्ये हेलिकल गिअर ची लोड कॅरिंग कॅपॅसिटी काय असते, जास्त असते. एज देट टूल्स आर इन्क्लाइन टू द शाफ्ट ऑफ द गिअर, सो दॅट इज हेलिकल गिअर. देन नेक्स्ट इज द हेरिंग बोन गिअर. हेरिंग बोन गिअर आर रिसेम्बल टू हेलिकल गिअर्स दॅट हॅव बीन प्लेस साइड बाय साइड. दोन हेलिकल गिअर साइड बाय साइड ठेवल्यानंतर काय करतं, that is a combination of two helical gears when placed side by side, then it forms the herringbone gear. So you can see that this is a combination of one helical gear and this is another combination of helical gear opposite directions. So the advantage of the herringbone gear is that it cannot be cut by simple gear hopping machine. हेरिंग बोन गिअर कट करणं काय सिम्पल हॉगिंग गिअर होतं, रिक्वायर्स मोर अटेन्शन. सो गिअर हॉगिंग कट आपण शिकायची पुढे, बरं, आफ्टर स्टडिंग दिस गिअर टाईप्स वेअर कोणते पर्सन गिअरचे बेसिक मोशन वर शिकायचं आपल्याला, गिअर हॉगिंग, गिअर फिनिशिंग, गिअर मोशनिंग. त्यानंतर गिअर हॉगिंग काय आपल्याला बघायचं, गिअर हॉगिंग मशीन्स गिअर गिअर आपल्याला गिअर हॉगिंग करायचं. सो it cannot be carried by simple gear hopping machine. So the disadvantage is gear hopping machine, but the normal gear hopping machine normal do that process is happen herringbone gear kar kar den nahi. Herringbone gear is usually referred to as double helical gear. The double helical gear is, but the fact is that herringbone is the type of helical gear with two helical gears joined together correctly of opposite helix. But lakshya dhe aapya, he don helical gear, sorry, he helical gears pe आणि दुसरे हेलिकल गिअर फेर दोन्ही अपोजिट केले आहेत, दोन्ही जॉईंट केले आहेत, अँड दे आर अपोजिट इन बरोबर. त्याचा हेलिक्स कसे आहे, ते दोन्ही अपोजिट हेलिक्स आहे, बरोबर. या हेलिक्स राईट हँड सपोज तर जाणार, हेलिक्स इज हॅव्हिंग लेफ्ट हँड, तो अपोजिट हेलिक्स दे आर हॅव्हिंग. So whereas in double helical gear there is a groove between two helical gears given in the tool run out for, बरोबर, आणि दोन हेलिकल गिअर मध्ये काय थोडी ग्रूव दिली, बघा देर इज नॉट डायरेक्टली प्रॉपरली मेश, देर इज गॅप, दॅट इज अ ग्रूव इन बिटवीन फॉर रन आउट, दॅट इज हेरिंग बोन गिअर. हेरिंग बोन गिअर लक्षात राहा सगळ्यांना स्टुडंट, देर इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ टू हेलिकल गिअर दॅट हॅव बीन प्लेस साइड बाय साइड, एंड वन ऑफ द डिसएडवांटेज इज दॅट इट कॅन नॉट बी कट बाय सिंपल गिअर हॉगिंग मशीन. स्टुडंट्स समजते कारण आपण टाइप्स ऑफ गिअर शिकतोय, लक्षात घ्या सगळ्यांनी. इन द फर्स्ट टाइप वी आर स्टडीड द स्पर गिअर. स्पर गिअर काय, इट इज मोस्ट वाईडली यूज गिअर वेअर गिअर टूब्स आर पॅरलल टू इच अदर, पॅरलल टू द एक्सिस ऑफ द शाफ्ट, दॅट इज
per gear, and second combination is called as a helical gear. The helical gears, the roots are inclined to the axis of the shaft. That is helical gear, and both gears are having tooth opposite in direction but of same size only, either left hand or either right hand combination. That is helical gear. The next combination gear system, that is a herringbone gear. In this herringbone gears, they are also
found reassembled two helical gears. Two helical gears combination there kela tha, herringbone gear there tha. Herringbone gear is referred to as a double helical gear, but the fact is that herringbone is a type of double gear with two helical gear. तो काय डबल गियर आहे ऑलरेडी बरोबर. त्या ठिकाणी असं टूल रनआउट साठी काय थोडीशी गॅप दिली जाते दोन्ही गियर कॉम्बिनेशन मध्ये. दॅट इज अ गॅप बिटवीन टू हेलिकल गियर्स. सो दॅट इज हेरिंगमोन गियर्स. नाउ नेक्स्ट गियर कॉल्ड एज अ बीवेन गियर ऑर मीटर गियर. इट इज इंटरसेक्टिंग बट कोप्लेनर शाफ्ट्स कनेक्टेड बाय गियर्स आर ड्यूअल गियर्स. आता गियर कसे ते शाफ्ट कसे ते इंटरसेक्टिंग शाफ्ट आहेत. पहिले शाफ्ट कसे होते in previous gears, they are parallel to each other. Suppose this axis of shaft or this previous these two axis gears, pahila gear cha axis hai shaft cha, so the shaft axis hai, the second gear cha axis the shaft hai. So both axes are in parallel, they are parallel to each other in both combination, either spur gear or either helical gear. You can see that. So both axes are in the parallel to each other. The axis central gear. इंटरसेक्टिंग एक्सिस called as a bevel gears. Straight bevel gear can be used on shaft by at any angle, but right angle is the most common. Straight bevel gears can be used at any angle, but normally right angle telescopic gear axis only that is most commonly used. That is straight bevel gears. There is zero bevel gear. Zero bevel gears are similar to straight bevel gears, but their teeth are curved lengthwise. Its teeth kaise hai curve ke lengthwise curve ke. These connected teeth of zero bevel gears are arranged in a manner that the effect of the spiraling is zero. Spiraling is effect zero. So guys, so zero asto in this zero bevel gear, whereas in spiral bevel gears that in this spiral bevel gear the teeth are oblique. Spiral bevel teeth are gears are quieter and can take up the more loads as compared to straight bevel gear. So these are the bevel gears having intersecting axis, intersecting and coplanar shafts. Shaft kasha kasha axis of shaft kasha center axis kasha 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 kasha. And you can access the shaft even center. So both axes are having intersecting in same plane. That is bevel gears. There are two types of bevel gears: spiral bevel gear or other zero bevel gear. These spiral bevel gears, the teeth are oblique. Spiral bevel gears are quieter and can take up more loads as compared to straight gears. Straight gear versus spiral gear मध्ये जास्त लोड येतात. Whereas zero bevel gears are similar to the straight bevel gears, but their teeth are inclined to the axis, called as a zero bevel gear. So arrange in manner that the effect of straight and spiral angle is zero. That is zero bevel gear. Then worm gear. So worm gear are used to transmit power at 90 degrees. So worm gears are used to transmit power at 90 degrees. That is worm gear.
As you can see, there is a worm is there. In worm gear, one gear has screw thread. Screw thread. Due to this, worm gears are quite vibration free and gives a smooth output. Worm gear shaft are also almost invariably at right angles. Worm gear shaft is like. So worm relay and worm gear shaft. That is combination of one shaft in the form of worm gear shaft and one is worm gear, round gear, that is worm gear. And they are transmitting the power at 90 degree where high reductions are required. Just the reduction karayche tevha mala worm gear vaparayche. In worm gears, worm gear has screw threads. Due to this, worm gears are quite vibration free and gives a smooth output. एकांश वाइब्रेशन कमी असतं वाइब्रेशन फ्री असतं गियर कॉम्बिनेशन वन गियर एंड वन गियर एंड वन गियर शाफ्ट ऑलमोस्ट इन वेरिएबल इन राइट एंगल्स बोथ आर अबाउट 90 डिग्री दैट्स व्हाट इज राइट एंगल्स देन वन गियर झाला वन गियर सगळ्यात सारा सिस्टम आता पुढचं गियर आपण रॅक एंड पिनियन रॅक एंड पिनियन हियर दैट शाफ्ट इज circular position shaft. On that circular shaft, there are tools. There is worm gear, but in the rack and pinion, on that rectangular plate, on that rectangular lengthwise plate, we can have that tools. So rack is a good bar and rod that can be out of a sector gear with an infinitely large radius of curvature. And pinion can be as a, considered as a spur gear. जे रोटरी गियर आहे त्याला काय म्हणतो आपण पिनियन म्हणतो बरोबर लक्षात घ्या स्टोन रॅक एंड पिनियन मध्ये काय आहे स्टेट जी असते ती स्टेट लाईन जी असते स्टेट लिंक असते ती दॅट इज अ रॅक ऍट हियर सो दॅट स्टेट स्टेट पोझिशन इज द रॅक एंड दॅट रोटरी गियर स्मॉल रोटरी गियर इज द पिनियन सो पिनियन कॅन बी कन्सिडर्ड एज अ स्पर गियर पिनियन काय म्हणतो शकतो आपण पिनियन कॅन बी कन्सिडर्ड एज अ स्पर गियर आपण स्पर गियर मध्ये बघितलं ना axis of gear is parallel to the axis of the shaft that is spur gear that is a pinion that rotary gear is also called as pinion which is basically a spur gear whereas that straight line surface of external tooth बरोबर हे आउटर सरफेस द टूथ इज त्याला काय म्हणतो आपण दॅट इज कॉल्ड एज अ रॅक सो टॉर्क कॅन बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू लिनियर फोर्सेस बाय मेशिंग अ रॅक विथ अ पिनियन opinion moves the rack in a straight line. Such a mechanism is used in automobile to convert the rotation of the steering wheel into the left to right motion of the rods. Steering wheel just up there for automobile motion. The steering wheel, the rotation ka karta hai, it is converted into left and right motion of the tire rod. Tire rod just the automobile wheel shall be moved. स्टेरिंग व्हील जास्त स्टेरिंग व्हील करतं रोटरी मुवमेंट करतं पण स्टेरिंग व्हील या रॅक एंड पिनियन खाली मेकॅनिझम लावलेलं असतं ते रोटरी मुवमेंट ऑफ स्टेरिंग व्हील इज टायर रॉड विथ द हेल्प ऑफ दिस रॅक एंड पिनियन असेंबली रॅक म्हणजे काय इट इज स्ट्रेट लाईन पार्ट इज द रॅक वेर एज दिस रोटरी कॉल्ड एज अ पिनियन Then next combination is internal gear or external gears means when these threads are on the internal side. So also this another external gear is combination with internal gear. That is an internal gear is one with the teeth form on the inner surface of a cylinder or cone. But the cylinder surface cha inner side la gear internal gear, whereas an external gear is one who with the teeth form on the outer surface of the cylinder or cone. The outer surface for cylinder cone or the tooth found there, that is the external gear. Whereas internal gear means the inner surface of the cylinder is having tooth. So that is the internal gear. So depending upon the combination of application, you have to require the types of gear, different types of gear. So either internal gear or the external gear. Then this is called as a phase gear. Phase gear transfers power at usually right angle in a circular motion bro phase gear mani ka hota they transmitting the power at usually right angle in the circular motion right angle mani circular motion mani transmit karte power the
phase gears are very not very common in industrial application. Phase gears just popular in the industry only. They use it another applications. That is phase gears. Then we'll go to the sprockets. Yes, sprocket just like your cycle level sprocket as well. Two wheeler level and four wheeler level sprocket system for your belt drive or chain drive. The sprockets are used to run chains. Sprocket is available the. This is a level chain. This is a level belt run on that. These are typically used in conveyor system. Industry will normally conveyor system just the for conveying the material from one end to other. In sugar carton, so the belt conveyor as to. काही काही रोलर कन्वेयर असतो त्या ठिकाणी काय होतं मटेरियल ट्रान्सफर फ्रॉम वन एंड टू अदर एंड विथ हेल्प ऑफ दिस स्प्रॉकेट्स एन इम्पॉर्टंट पार्ट इज कन्वेयर सिस्टम कन्वेयर सिस्टम इज वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टंट पार्ट नो दे आर यूज इन द चेन टाइप्स इन मोटरसायकल एंड बायसिकल्स दिस स्प्रॉकेट्स दे आर यूज इन द चेन टाइप्स एंड मोटरसायकल्स एंड बायसिकल्स दैट इज योर स्प्रॉकेट्स No classification according to the plane or axis of the shaft. The parallel axis could be square gear, helical gear, right hand pinion, intersecting gear could be bevel gear, intersecting axis. Non-intersecting and non-parallel gears are called as worm and worm gears. That is classification according to the axis of the shaft. Upon both the square gear and the axis of the teeth and axis of shaft, they are both parallel to each other. Whereas helical gear and the axis of tooth is inclined, but axis of shaft is parallel. They also rack and pinion was the same. The axis of shaft is also parallel, but whereas intersecting, the bevel gears are having intersecting axis, and non-intersecting and non-parallel, that worm and worm gears. Worm and worm gears are that is neither intersecting nor parallel to each other. That is worm and worm gears. So in this case, this is the rack and pinion. Suppose this is the circular part is pinion, and this straight line part is what is the rack. So in that way, here studied these types of gears. We just have this first. In short, we just have that summary of the types of gear. After कुटले gear से class बगा student. Spur gear मध्ये काय axis of tooth are parallel to the axis of shaft passing through the center. That is spur gear. Whereas helical gears they are not having parallel tooth. They are having the inclined helix in the form of helix, which are inclined at the axis of the shaft. That is helical gear. Then when we are combining two helical gears, that is called as a herringbone gear combination. Two helical gears, that is herringbone gear. Then next is bevel gear. This bevel gear is having not parallel shaft but having intersecting shaft. Both shafts are intersecting to each other at an required angle, depending upon the type of motion. So that is intersecting or bevel gear. And next is called the worm gear. Worm wheels are there. They are mounted on worms. That is a worm gear. Then the rack and pinion. Straight line path. That is a rack is there. And rotary small spur gear, which is called as a pinion. So that different machine tools must be to convert the rotary motion into pinion motion. Or in your steering mechanism also, you can convert the rotary motion of into left and right formation of that tri rod in your automobile. That is rack and pinion. Then we also studied this internal and external gear. Then we just look on that phase gear or sprockets.
Sorry, internal and external. Check one for it.
Upon bagitlo the spur gear kai, their axes are parallel and coplanar. They are all spur gears, properly meshed, and they only. Sorry. Their advantages is simplicity in design, and also economically managed and maintenance, and there is no such end thrust on that load.
teeth or hairs loaded in. And square gears are most common types of gears. They are also called as the speed gears. And there are the straight teeth. That is the parallel to the axis of the wheel. That is square gear. Helical gear means what is happening? Their axis of the teeth are inclined to the axis of the shaft in the form of helix. That is helical gear. The most common helical gear is smoother and quieter than the motion of square gear. But that is helical gear. The angle of the helix on both gear must be same in 90 degrees. That is value same as the value. Angle same as the value, but must be opposite in direction, either right hand direction or the left hand direction while movement. They are used generally as a high speed gears, that is helical gears. Then this herringbone gears, combination of two helical gears, that is the herringbone gear. Herringbone is usually referred to as a double helical gear, but the fact is that herringbone is a type of double gear with two helical gears joined together currently of opposite helix, and they don't have any clearance between them. Well, that is double helical gear, where is a groove between two helical gears for the tool run out. Tools run out satisfies the double helical gear manika hai. There is a groove dili or actually groove dili hai. The double helical gear manika that groove is between two helical gears that for tool run out satisfies the lastly. After straining the helical gear, the next intersecting type of gears, their shafts are intersecting. But coplanar shaft are called as a bevel gears. There are two types of bevel gears, either spiral bevel gear or either zero bevel gears. So that is bevel gear. Then worm and worm gear. Worm gears are most commonly used in 90 degree angle. That is worm gear. The worm gears are straight and almost invariably at right angles also. That is worm gear. A rotary part of the worm manka, the straight line part, that is worm gear shaft. That is worm gear. Then this is called as a rack and pinion. So if someone says a straight line part, that is a rack, and this rotary spur gear, it is a pinion. So that is a rack and pinion. They use it in different machine tools. So there are also the internal national gears. The internal gear guys, students, normally in your different applications also, it is not like always you have to have that external tooth like this external gear. External gear proper external tooth by jaisa kahani. In some cases there is a combination of external gear as well as this internal gear. Ha motor gear jo ka hai kaisa hai to, that is internal gear is one with the teeth formed in the inner surface of a cylinder. The cylindrical surface cha inner surface var gear tooth form zale or inner surface of cylindrical or either cone conical surface. When these teeth are formed internally, then it is called as a internal gear. Bolo नॉर्मली क्या होता है गियर बाहर मेस होता ना इधर एक्सटर्नल गियर मतलब कैसा गेस दैट वन स्मॉल गियर वन स्मॉल पिनियन गियर इज मेस विद द गियर दैट इज एक्सटर्नली बट व्हेन दैट एक्सटर्नल मेशिंग इज नॉट प्रॉपर वेरी लेस और फ्यू देन इन दैट केस वी हैव टू मेस द गियर्स इन इंटरनली हाँ एक्सटर्नल गियर का सब मेस जा रहा है तो इंटरनल मेस जा रहा है बरो म्हणून वॉच मध्ये वर सुद्धा असे करत अशा प्रकारचे थोडे इंटरनल गिअर असतात आपल्या हँड वॉच मध्ये वगैरे. इंटरनल गिअर काय दे आर हॅविंग द टूथ और टीथ फॉर्म ऑन द इनर सर्फेस ऑफ सिलेंडर दैट इज इनर गिअर. इनर गिअर्स आर हॅविंग इंटरनल टूथ ऑन इट्स in the cylinder, that is internal gear. Then external gear, an external gear is one with teeth formed on the outer surface of a cone, that is a external gear. Some other student koni chala tha. Hello
sir, external gear la spur gear manu shakto ka apan?
Ha, external gear is a spur gear, barobar hai. Tyache teeth kasya prakarche lakshat ye students, that external gear la they tooth, whether they are parallel to each other, parallel, the tooths are parallel to the axis of the shaft. Ya tikani kay, they are parallel to the axis of the shaft, then it is a spur gear. But if the tooths are not parallel,
देन इट कैन बी अ हेलिकल गियर. बट एक्सटर्नल गियर काय आहे, एक्सटर्नल गियर म्हणजे त्याच्या एक्सटर्नल सर्फेस वर गियर आहे, एक्सटर्नल आउटर पेरिफेरी वर देर आर टूल्स, आयदर ऑन द सिलेंड्रिकल सर्फेस ऑर आयदर कोनिकल सर्फेस, दॅट इज अ एक्सटर्नल गियर. बट वेर एज इंटरनली काय आहे, दॅट टूल्स आर फॉर्म ऑन द इनर सर्फेस ऑफ द सिलेंडर ऑर कोन, दॅट इज इंटरनल गियर. ओके, then face gears, they are not having very common industrial applications, but there are the face gears usually have right angle in a circular motion. So these are the different types of gears. Then also we have the sprocket. Sprocket ke aapla cycle madhe or ek two wheelers madhe pan aapla automobile madhe pan sprocket. Sprockets are used to run chains or belt. Sprockets are outer side edge pins hai, outside edge tooth hai. Tyavar ka hota belt or chain is assembled and after that sprocket movement, that motion will be transferred with the help of this sprocket. Very second cycle only or both the best of bigger wheel and smaller wheel. So bigger wheel or smaller wheel also have this small sprocket. These sprockets are used mainly for sprockets are used in many chain drives in motorcycles and bicycles. So upon both those sprockets. चेन टाइप जैसे चेन चेन टाइप दिस मोटरसाइकिल में के बाइक में भी वापस आता है, दैट इज स्प्रॉकेट्स. सो स्प्रॉकेट्स आर देयर. देन क्लासिफिकेशन अकॉर्डिंग टू द एक्सिस ऑफ द शाफ्ट. अपन एक्सिस तीन प्रकार के एक्सिस बोलते होगा, पैरेलल एक्सिस लाइक स्क्वायर गियर, हेलिकल गियर और रैक एंड पिनियन गियर, एंड इंटरसेक्टिंग एक्सिस कुछ होता है ड्यूअल गियर में इंटरसेक्टिंग एक्सिस, एंड नॉन पैरेलल एक्सिस को नॉन इंटरसेक्टिंग नॉन पैरेलल. That is worm and worm gear. That is not intersecting as well, not parallel also. So these are the classification of axis of gear. Well, students, so in this way, students, we are studying this gear management part. In that gear management part, today we are studying these different types of gear. These are the different types of gear which are used at various industrial applications. Now. In the next lecture, we are going to study the next part of the gear, that is gear hopping. There is gear hopping. So gear hopping, it is a gear management method in which we have to produce the gear by particular process called as gear hopping. आपण gear hopping थोडक्यात बघायचं आपल्याला कुठच्या process मध्ये. मग gear hopping काय आपण थोडक्यात आज बघूया. Just we'll go to that. Slide just me. So students, just a minute, let me screen share got to five. पुढच्या लेक्चरला आपल्याला आता गियर असं गियर प्रोस गियर वाईजिंग मेथड शिकायचे वन बाय वन, गियर हॉपिंग, गियर लॅपिंग, गियर हॉनिंग. सो दिस आर द प्रोसेस वी हैव टू स्टडी इन डिटेल्स. बेसिकली गियर मॅनेजमेंट काय आहे, गियर मॅनेजमेंट कॅन बी डिवाइडेड इनटू टू कॅटेगरीज, फॉर्मिंग अँड मशीनिंग. बरोबर, गियर मॅनेजमेंट ज्याच्या मेथड आपल्याला शिकायचे पुढच्या वर्ष दोन कॅटेगरी बेसिकली फॉर्मिंग करू शकतो. गियर आयदर वी कॅन फॉर्म द गियर, आयदर वी कास्टिंग, फोर्जिंग, स्टॅम्पिंग, सो वी कॅन फॉर्म इट ऑर आयदर वी कॅन मशीन इट, मशीनिंग इट. सो मशीनिंग मीन्स गियर हॉपिंग. सो गियर हॉपिंग इज वन ऑफ द मशीनिंग प्रोसेस, गियर शेपिंग, रफिंग. सो फॉर्मिंग कसे जो डायरेक्ट कास्टिंग, मोल्डिंग, ड्रॉइंग ऑर एक्सप्लेन ऑफ टू फॉर्म्स इन मोल्डन पाउडर अँड हिट सॉफ्टन मटेरियल्स. मशीनिंग इन्वॉल्व्स रफिंग अँड फिनिशिंग ऑपरेशन्स. बरं, फॉर्मिंग काय असतं, फॉर्मिंग म्हणजे डायरेक्ट कास्टिंग प्रोसेस आहे, ड्रॉइंग एक्सप्लेन टू फॉर्मेशन, दॅट इज अ फॉर्मिंग प्रोसेस. वेअरएज मशीनिंग इन्वॉल्व्स रफिंग अँड फिनिशिंग ऑपरेशन. सो गियर मॅनेजमेंट प्रोसेस मध्ये आपण फॉर्मिंग अँड मशीनिंग प्रोसेस शिकायचं आपल्या पुढे. मग कास्टिंग, सिंटरिंग, इंजेक्शन मोल्डिंग, एक्सक्लुडिंग, कोल्ड ड्रॉइंग, स्टॅम्पिंग, reforming, forging, their forming processes. We have formed the surface or we have formed the
सेल इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ फॉर्मिंग. देयर इज इन्वर्शन बाय यूजिंग सम बिगर रॉ मटेरियल, बाय यूजिंग सम रॉ मटेरियल ऑफ डिफरेंट साइज वी आर फिनिशिंग द रिक्वायर्ड गियर आइदर बाय दिस नंबर ऑफ मशीनिंग प्रोसेसेस. मशीनिंग में क्या है, रफिंग, फॉर्म मेटिंग, रैक जनरेशन, गियर शेपिंग, हॉबिंग, देयर आर मशीनिंग प्रोसेस. देयर आर सम फिनिशिंग प्रोसेस लाइक फिनिशिंग, शेविंग, ग्राइंडिंग, बर्निशिंग, लैपिंग, हॉनिंग. म्हणजे आयदर गिअर मशीन केलं तर काय रफ साईज आपल्याला काय मिळते, गिअर हॉबिंग. त्या गिअर हॉबिंग आपल्याला फिनिश साईज द्यायची आहे. फिनिश साईज देतो अशा प्रकारचं फिनिशिंग, शेविंग, ग्राइंडिंग, बर्निशिंग, लॅपिंग किंवा हॉनिंग अशा प्रकारच्या फिनिशिंग प्रोसेस वापरल्या जर ह्या प्रोसेस आपण कुठे डिटेलमध्ये शिकू. सपोज गिअर हॉबिंग करतो आपण, गिअर फॉरवर्ड एक्सप्लोजन करतो आपण, इन दिस गिअर एक्सप्लोजन प्रोसेस
मला काय माहिती
आवाज येतोय का रे? हॅलो.
येस सर.
हो सर, येतोय येतोय.
सो स्टुडंट, ऑल दिस गिअर मॅनेजिंग प्रोसेस, गिअर मशीनिंग और गिअर मॅन्युफॅक्चरिंग, गिअर शेपिंग प्रोसेस आपल्याला पुढच्या लेक्चरला बघायचं आहे. आज आपण थोडक्यात गिअर टाईप्स बघितले, लाईक स्पर गिअर, विच इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड स्पीड गिअर और हेलिकल गिअर. हेलिकल गिअर्स इज देअर, देन ऑल्सो देर इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ टू हेलिकल गिअर, हेरिंग बोन गिअर, देन इंटरसेक्टिंग गिअर लाईक बीवेल गिअर, देन वर्म अँड वर्म गिअर, वर्म शाफ्ट अँड वर्म, रोटरी वर्म, देन इम्पॉर्टंटली रॅक अँड पिनियन, मोस्टली यूज इन मशीन टूल्स. दॅट स्ट्रेट लाईन पार्ट इज अ रॅक अँड दॅट सर्क्युलर गिअर इज द पिनियन गिअर, विच इज अ स्पर गिअर. अँड ऑल्सो दॅट रॅक अँड पिनियन गिअर इज इम्पॉर्टंटली यूज इन मशीन टूल्स. देन इंटरनल अँड एक्सटर्नल गिअर्स. सो दीज आर द डिफरंट टाइप्स ऑफ गिअर्स वी आर स्टडीड. And in the next lecture, we'll start with the gear management methods. Is it clear, students? Can you tell us about it? You can ask if there is any question before completing the lecture.